Greetings, and welcome to our CodeMeter tutorial series. In this segment, we will talk about firm code and product code. When you choose to use CodeMeter to protect and license your software, you will come across the terms firm code and product code again and again. Let's have a closer look at their definition and how crucial they are in protecting and licensing your software. In your role as ISV, you are first going to integrate CodeMeter into your software. An easy option is to use CodeMeter Protection Suite and encrypt the entire application. Additionally, you can use CodeMeter Core API to integrate license checks into your software. For the encryption process, you need a cryptographic key. This key is automatically derived from firm code and product code. In a second stage, you are going to create a license and deliver it to your sample user. The license includes the same firm code and product code that you have used during the protection process. This ensures that the right cryptographic key is available on the user side for starting your software. Firm code and product code are thus the vital connection between the integration of CodeMeter into your software and the creation of the protected software license. To make sure this cryptographic key is stored securely on the user side, CodeMeter offers three types of CodeMeter containers. Let's take a quick look at the available types of CM containers. CM dongle, the hardware-based container, embeds a smart card chip. All license information like firm code and product code, as well as the cryptographic keys, are stored inside the smart card chip. This makes this solution most secure and also mobile. Alternatively, you can use a software-based container, which we call CM Act License. This is an encrypted license file, which is bound to the hardware properties of a computer or a target device. The binding is realized with asymmetric encryption, where the computer fingerprint acts as the private key. Therefore, the encrypted license file cannot be decrypted at another computer or device. Thanks to a tolerance mechanism patented under the name of SmartBind, the license stays valid, even if some hardware properties have changed over time. For virtual machines and cloud services like Azure, SmartBind creates the fingerprint as a special mixture of hardware and environmental properties. For instance, this ensures that moving the virtual machine is allowed and its cloning is forbidden. The third option you have at your disposal in terms of license containers is storing the license in the cloud permanently and assigning it to a user account. This is your preferred choice for extreme mobility, as you can use the license with any device or via cloud-based services. All three types of CM containers can be used with a license server in a local or wide area network. This is how you can set up floating network licenses, also known as concurrent network licenses. Let's circle back to the terms firm code and product code where we began. A license consists of a firm code and product code. We've already learned that we need to use the same firm code and product code during both the software protection and the license creation phases. The firm code is issued by WIBU-SYSTEMS. First and foremost, it's a top priority for our team to make sure that each firm code is unique. This is the fundamental prerequisite for you to be the one and only vendor who can create, modify, and delete licenses with your unique firm code. When placing your first order for CodeMeter technology, you receive the firm code already set in a master dongle known as the Firm Security Box, or FSB. The FSB should be plugged into your computer during the protection and the creation processes of your licenses. Unlike the firm code, you choose your product codes. Each product code is an unsigned integer value. So you'll have 4 billion product codes available. Best practices recommend using a different product code for every product, module, and feature that you want to sell separately. In our sample, we're using product code 201.000 for a basic version of our software, and product codes 201.001 and 201.002 for two additional features. A user who purchases the basic version gets only product code 201.000. A different user, who purchases our software with two additional modules, gets all three product codes. Each product code is located inside a product item. you can store up to 2,000 product items, which means 2,000 product codes, in one CM container. The product item is defined by the product code. It can be defined further by a number of license options called the product item options. Let's look in detail of some of the most critical product item options. We start with text and license quantity. Text is a simple description of the product, module, or feature. License quantity defines the amount of floating concurrent network licenses. You can also apply time-based options. Activation time is the time from which the license is valid. Expiration time is the time in which the license is no longer valid. And usage period is the duration expressed in days for as long as the license is valid from its first use. If you want to monitor version control, you have recourse to the following options. If you sell dedicated versions, Feature Map allows you to define different versions, including upgrade and downgrade rights. This product item option works like a bit mask, where every bit represents an allowed version. Maintenance period is the option of your choice if you sell your licenses with a maintenance contract independent from the software version. And you can obviously combine these two options. Whereas the license expires if you set the expiration time, in this case, the license stays valid even after reaching the end of the maintenance period. The user can still use the latest version, which was released during the maintenance period they signed up for. Module items offer an elegant way to group products and features. It is essentially a product item nested inside another product item. Features can be defined as module items and assigned to a parent product item. The feature inherits all license options from the parent item. You don't need to define the license options twice. The unit counter can be used for pay-per-use licenses. It can either be set to a defined value for prepaid licenses or to the maximum threshold and used downwards to count postpaid billing units. You also have a number of security-related options like maximum encryption rate, access password, and minimum runtime version. The first two are used in the award-winning encryption technology, Blurrybox. There are more advanced options too. Named user license binds the license to a defined user. Linger time is useful if your software runs only for a couple of seconds or minutes and you want to sell it in a concurrent network license mode. A very strategic option is license transfer. With it, you can borrow a license from a network server, transfer it to a local CM container, and use it remotely without any connection to the network server. Lastly, there are some additional data options that have different sizes and access rights. A sample, which is often used to clarify their value, consists of storing the name of the user in customer-owned license information. Hidden, secret, and universal data can be used for storing additional cryptographic keys. For software protection and licensing purposes, you don't need to define these additional keys. There is already a key derived from the firm code and product code, which CodeMeter creates and delivers automatically, and which is used by CodeMeter Protection Suite. This concludes this segment of our CodeMeter tutorial series. Thank you very much for your interest in the small introduction about firm code and product code. As always, we wish you great success with CodeMeter and your business.